Hi everyone, my name is Martin Hoffmann from the Chair of Bioinformatics in the Friedrich Schiller University Jena, and in this video we're going to talk about how to export an OpenMS analysis for Sirius 4. So in this tutorial I will assume basic knowledge about OpenMS, but if you prefer a different export method, please just see the links in the description. You can find detailed information as well as documentation and the software used in this tutorial on the official OpenMS website here. And for the sake of visual clarity, this tutorial will show the graphical user interface top pass. All modules and steps used and taken can of course also be used with the command line version. So once top pass is installed and running, we can start by setting our input file. In this video, we will be using a raw file exported by Excalibur. It is unprocessed, and of course also other different input files are supported. Check the OpenMS documentation for a complete list. Okay, so once we have imported our file, we can now start by converting it into the more generic MZML format. So for that we are going to use the file converter over here, and then double click it, bring up its advanced parameters and go to OutType and set MZML over here. After doing that, we can now link our input file to the file converter like this, and we have now converted our input file into an MZML file. Please note that the MZML file we have just converted is still in profiled mode, and Sirius 4 only supports centroided data. So that is why we cannot just export at this step, but need to do some additional work. So next up, we're going to add the Feature Finder Metabo module in the Quantitation tab over here, add it to your pipeline and bring up its advanced parameters like this. And in this module, there are some very important parameters that vary greatly between different setups, instruments and data types. So it's very important that you choose sensible values here. Going over the most important settings, we're going to start with the noise intensity threshold over here. This is an intensity value, and all the peaks in your data below this value will be considered noise. So it's very important that you go into your data, you look at it, and you choose a noise threshold value that is sensible for your data. Don't just trust the threshold here, choose whatever's best for your data. Then afterwards, we have the expected chromatographic peak width. Once again, this is very dependent on your chromatographic setup, so look into your data, see what the average peak width is or the peak width you would accept, and then set this value accordingly. Going to the mass error in ppm setting, this is obviously dependent on your instrument type, so what kind of mass accuracy you expect. Just set this accordingly and make sure it fits your instrument type. Then, going a bit lower here, we have the isotope filtering model, which should be set to none. This is just to prevent unnecessary filtering of isotopic peaks, since Sirius 4 uses these for molecular formula computation. Then you can confirm the parameters and connect the file converter to your Feature Finder Metabo module and move to the next step. Next up, in utils over here, we're going to use the Metabolite ETAG Decharger module. Once again, add it to your pipeline and open its advanced parameters. This module is mostly used for ETAG detection, so one of the most important settings here is that if you have prior knowledge about your data and you know you expect some kind of adduct that is not already present in this list here, then feel free to follow the instructions on the help panel to add it as a possible adduct. Also, if you have measured your data in negative ion mode, then enable the negative ion mode in here. Okay, I will just confirm this for now, and we can now connect our Feature Finder Metabo module to the Metabolite adduct decharger like this. We are going to choose Feature XML in both fields, and now we are ready for the actual exporting process. So for that we are going to use, once again in utils, the Sirius adapter, add it to your workflow, open up the settings, and at this point it's very important to understand that the Sirius adapter can do much more than just exporting spectral data. It can actually compute Sirius and CSI finger ID results just directly from this pipeline in OpenMS. But in this tutorial, we are just focusing on how to get the input data for the actual Serious User Interface, so we are going to skip that. And the only setting we are interested in here is the converter mode here, which will make it so nothing is actually computed and we are just outputting or converting our files that we have input here into a serious readable format. So we are setting this to true here. We are confirming, and then we are connecting the metabolite ADAC decharger to the serious adapter. We are choosing, we have now the choice between three different output types here. And we are going to go with feature XML, and we're also going to go with feature XML at the target, which is a serious adapter. Now the serious adapter also needs a second input, which is an MZML file. Remember, our input was a raw file, and our MZML file is stored in the file converter here. So we are connecting the file converter to serious as well, and choosing MZML over here. Now everything is basically done, and the only thing left to do is save our output. For that, we are creating an output object, and we are linking it to our serious adapter. And we can now choose which of these three outputs here that the serious adapter outputs are what we want to save. Outfinger ID and outSerious are only produced when Serious or CSI Finger ID results are computed. But remember, we are only in converter mode, so we can only export this here, outMS, which is the MS spectrum that we are interested in. So confirming once again, now our pipeline is finished. And we can now go to pipeline and run, set our desired output directory, confirm again, and once this pipeline is finished, you will then find an Excalibur MS file, or whatever your file was named, in the desired output folder. And this file is now ready to just get drag and dropped into Sirius and start your analysis.